Hi, I'm Mike Shibarasi, Agricultural Business Management Specialist with UNH Cooperative Extension. In the last video, we discussed how to allocate direct costs among farm enterprises. In this video, we will discuss or address how to assess indirect costs for those enterprises. Indirect costs are those expenses which are not readily identified with a specific enterprise or product. These include costs that are incurred irrespective of production levels. Examples would be machinery and building depreciation, interest on capital, essential repairs and maintenance, property taxes, and business insurance. Indirect costs also include other shared expenses not clearly identified with a specific crop: utilities, general farm supplies, advertising, and promotion are good examples of these shared costs. Robert and Mary started identifying indirect costs by first re-examining their income statement and then listing expense categories that were not assigned to a specific enterprise in direct cost calculations. Mary realized after taking the advanced farm management course that these expenses needed to be included in the price of the product they sold to ensure that they were covering their costs. So she took the indirect costs associated with field machinery and allocated these costs among enterprises based on the percentage of total acres covered. Mary could have divided machinery costs based on total number of hours used, but because farm production records weren't that extensive, she chose to allocate field machinery indirect costs by acres covered. So when you have indirect costs associated with facilities like a greenhouse or a farm stand, there are two common ways to allocate those indirect costs among enterprises. The first is to allocate the indirect costs based on the amount of square footage space that particular enterprise uses. The second is to look at total sales of each crop and to allocate the indirect costs on the basis of percentage sales. For example, if a sweet corn display takes up 10% of the retail stand, then sweet corn would be assessed 10% of the farm stand facility costs. Alternatively, if sweet corn generated 25% of total dollar sales from that stand, then you could allocate 25% of the farm stand costs to this enterprise. Since every farm situation is different, you need to consider if one of these approaches is appropriate or if some other alternative is the best way to allocate indirect costs for your farm. There are two additional items to be concerned about when dealing with indirect costs. First, annual depreciation should be based on the economic life of the asset, not the period of time of which it's been depreciated for tax purposes. Second, you should address opportunity costs. There are two important categories of opportunity costs. One is return to the owner's labor and management efforts, and the other is return to the owner's personal funds invested in the farm business. Robert and Mary determined that each needed $55,000 in compensation for their labor and management efforts. Robert's wife didn't agree with the self-determined level of compensation, but his daughter knew better than to get in the middle of that discussion, so he remained at $55,000. Hence, a total of $110,000 was required for owner's labor and management. This $110,000 would be allocated across the different enterprises. The logic for charging for personal funds invested in a farm business is that you could have invested them elsewhere, such as the stock market or money market funds, and earned interest. Therefore, when determining cost of production, the cost of using your personal funds should be included as part of the farm expense. One way of determining this opportunity cost would be to recognize the money you invested in the farm and multiply it by an annual interest rate. The money you have invested in the farm is your equity or net worth. The annual interest rate should reflect the rate of returns that could realistically have been earned by your equity in an alternative investment, such as the stock market. An alternative approach is to assess average farm asset values on the balance sheet and use those values to determine a cost for both your funds and borrowed funds. The rate of return used to calculate this cost should reflect the opportunity cost associated with your investment and the interest cost charged on loans. For money invested in land, you determine the average annual value of the property and multiply it by an appropriate annual rate of return. For depreciable assets, you add their beginning and ending values, divide by 2, and multiply the result by an appropriate annual rate of return to derive costs associated with the investment. Robert and Mary determined that the total opportunity cost on the land should be $22,629. This was calculated by taking a rate of return of 5% and subtracting 2% for annual depreciation to get a net charge of 3% per year. Then the average annual land value of $754,300 was multiplied by 3% to get the $22,629. Keep in mind that overall indirect costs will be higher than those shown on the income statement, because an income statement does not account for opportunity costs. Once we have the indirect costs allocated amongst the enterprise, we'll combine those with the direct costs and look at overall cost of production.